Hey there, Chris Wells here, and today we're going to be looking at how to create smooth transitions between your audio clips. So let's give this sequence a cheeky little play. So as you can see, we've got a bit of a hard transition there between the kinds of sounds. So on the forest side, we've got two layers of sounds here. We've got, let's just solo the tracks by using this button here. So we've got the sounds of the birds chirping. And if I solo this track, we've also got the sounds of the fire. Very subtle there. And then on this side, it's just the sound of the car. And creatively, I decided to go for the sound of inside the car because it's like subjectively, it's like the perspective of the characters inside the car looking out. Because, you know, if it was actually outside the car, it would just be like very windy, which we don't really want, because I feel like, you know, I want this kind of dreamlike, whimsical kind of mood for the film. So to go with that, we've got a nice little cross dissolve here, you know, but the sound doesn't do that. So what we want is we want to kind of make that sound transition with it. So there's actually a couple of different ways we can do it. The first way is we can just zoom in a little bit, is we can just go up here to toggle audio levels editing, and let's just go to solo. So this is the fire sounds, and what we do is we go to the top right corner where this little triangle appears, and we click and we drag, and this will start to create a fade. And what I want to do is I actually want the fire to start fading quite a bit before. So this is going to fade, you can see there's a little number there, 26 frames, so that's actually over a second. So let's just play that now. There we go, and it fades as it transitions in. So it's going to kind of add a lot longer. So let's just play that now and let's see how that goes. So obviously the fire fades out quite nicely, and that works quite well, but we've still got the hard transition of these two sounds here. So what we want to do for that one is we want to go up to effects, then to audio, and then we've got a crossfade here. And the easiest way to get the right length from the crossfade that we want is to kind of scrub our playhead to where we want that transition to go. And I'm going to literally do it in time with the dissolve. So I'm just going to drag it to the start of the dissolve. And then on our keyboard, I'm going to press I to set an endpoint. And then I'm just going to drag another point here, which is, as you can see, we've created a little marked area here. Find the crossfade, which I've already got selected here. So there we go, I've got a crossfade. And then down here, it says which region it wants the crossfade to go into. And we've got here marked section, which is what this area is here. Press apply. Oh, and I've accidentally added it to both, which we don't want to do. So I'm just going to control Z, bam, and do that. And to make it not go onto both, all I've got to do is go across and click on the track here to deselect it and then press apply, and bam, and you'll see it's applied to it just on the single track. And then all I've got to do is reactivate the track, and then you'll see it's applied it to just that clip. As I've dragged it back, you'll see I've accidentally, the playhead is still dragging a marked area. So to get rid of that, all I've got to do is press P on the keyboard to clear all the marked areas. So there we go. And then I can just drag that back. And now let's play it all and see how it all goes. There we go. That sounds much better. And just one last quick tip. Once you have finished doing all of your audio levels, don't forget to deselect the toggle audio levels editing button up here so you can go back to editing all of the video aspects of your video.